We have Beverly with us, and she's the audience and join us. You joined today, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
Would you like to say something about today's program?
This is something that everybody should experience, especially in this time of day where we all looking for guidance and love and to connect. And this has been such a wonderful experience for me. This is my first time, and I will be back many, many times and bring other friends to join.
Thank you so much. I am happy you liked it.
Thank you.
We have Ajay Jain, and he's a volunteer since yesterday, right?
Yes. And I've been volunteer with Art of Living for many, many years.
So he is the right person to talk about. Tell me about this event.
So this event was Get Happy Boston. So it was an introduction to the Art of Living, you know, Happy program. You know, Art of Living courses were like, you know, long, 6 days and 3 hours a day. So it's about 18 hours program. And a lot of people who are busy are unable to provide the time during the weekdays. So we have divided the whole program into two. And this was the first part of the program. And you just witnessed that more than 1,000 people actually had come and enjoyed this program for last 2 days. And Sri Ravi Shankar himself was here. He took meditation yesterday and today. And both days, like almost about 30 minutes. And it was an awesome meditation. You might have witnessed that yourself as well.
So, as you said, as you have a chapter in Boston.
Yes, of course.
Tell our audience about that.
Oh, sure, yeah. So in Boston chapter is a very vibrant chapter. In fact, it's not just in Boston. It's all over Massachusetts, actually. Not all over New England or all over the world, for that matter. But yes, in Boston, we have regular courses and being held at MIT, Harvard, Burlington, Westboro, and then there are certain parts also in Quincy area, and Maynard area. So there are several places where regularly courses are being held, and people in that area can go and do these courses. And we also, after the course is done, you know, we also meet on a follow-up sessions where people who have done the course can come and meet and repeat what the Sudarshan Kriya among themselves. So, and in all these centers, you know, we have regular follow-ups as well.
That's wonderful. Who is the key person?
Oh, there are several. There are several teachers here and key volunteers as well. Rajini is one of them. Dinidza is another one. Ram and Dhanashri are another then. Michelle Petty, Chuck Foster. There are quite a few.
Yes, few actually. Thank you so much, Ajay.
Always my pleasure.
Thank you so much. Pleasure. Thank you. So we have Karuna here. She is a participant. Tell me about your experience today.
It was definitely very wonderful to see Guruji in person and just to do the different, the yoga practices and the breathing techniques and everything. I think definitely it made me feel a lot more energetic and rejuvenated. So, it was very
would you like to join Art of Living?
Sure. We have been participating in the past. Through other friends, but definitely, you know.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Mr. Sheldas. Another participant from today's workshop, JJ and Patricia. Tell me about your experience of today's workshop.
It was a wonderful gathering. I could meet with people around the world, I would say. They are not only Indians, but there are people from like different ethnicities and cultures. And we had a great time talking with them, enjoying time, and just making new friends.
It was a great experience, and I thoroughly enjoyed the meditation part with Sri Sri, and it was very special because Sri Sri was here, and it is more a nice experience because I volunteered as well. So helping out people and watching them out was a nice experience for me.
Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
Veronica, welcome at BDC TV.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you? So tell me about today's experience. What is your feeling about today's program, actually?
I feel that we are very lucky to have a teacher like Sri Ravi Shankar. I really appreciate him being so flexible and coming around the world and teaching the knowledge that he gives. I'm also one of the teachers I've been in Art of Living for 20 years, and I'm privileged to be his instrument to give the knowledge and spread the joy and everybody around me. And originally I came from Uzbekistan, Tashkent, and now currently I live in Florida, and I also teach kids course, and which call Art Excel, and yes, Youth Empowerment Seminar and Happiness Program. And so I am just want to say that the feeling about this program today, that people feel uplifted, happy. Meditation is a great tool to have, to feel content, to feel clear. And like Guruji said today, it's a high mental hygiene.
Perfect. Thank you so much for talking about. Jep, thank you so much. We have Amit Dixit here, my dear friend and very familiar and well-known face from Boston. Amit, welcome at BDC TV.
Thank you, Razia. You know, it's always a pleasure to see you. And first of all, I want to thank you. Unlike other press in Boston, you were here yesterday, you were here from the seminar, and you're here tonight. And
thank
I want
you
to ask
so
you, how much did you appreciate this?
No, it's not appreciated. I mean, this kind of events, we must be there. I mean, we cannot pretend we will be.
It's not just about a photo op, it's about experience. And that's why I'm so glad that you were here.
Thank you so much for your appreciation. And tell me about your journey of 2 days.
Well, it's been quite an exciting journey. I've been working with the Art of Living folks for the past few weeks and helping them background and so forth. And I had the distinct honor of going and meeting with Sri Sri this morning in his hotel room with Nam Pham, who is the Undersecretary of Business Development for the Commonwealth, and as well as Mary Trong, who is a very dear friend, also Commissioner of Immigration and Refugee. And Mary couldn't make it tonight because she's getting awarded. And the proclamation that was done, we presented it to Sri in the morning, but they wanted to present officially here tonight. So it was an honor for me to represent Governor Baker and Lieutenant Governor Polito to do that.
So wonderful. So you are here. I see so many people around here. So did you have talk with, what is the response of the crowd?
Well, I think, you know, as you know, we did International Yoga Day at the State House. And thank you for being there again. So plug for Daisy, for Boston Daisy. You're always there, and I really respect that. The thing is that what we need to do is bring our cultural heritage outward. Just as we discussed at International Yoga Day, which was the first time, as well as here. I mean, 1,000+ people. It was amazing. And, you know, this is my first Art of Living. You know, my Ankita, who is my intern, she's been, Amit, you've got to go. And it just, you know, kismat ki baat, it just happened. And here I am, and being in the same room with Sri Sri in the morning. And, you know, I told the organizers the only reason I'm doing this, in many reasons, but the one reason is because his inclusive stance on LGBT issues. For him to say, to talk against 377 as being an archaic law, to me held a very personal acceptance. And that's true love. That is true love. And that's why I work very hard and work with AOL groups to say, this is my seva. Because his message was heard. And today in his room, when I spoke with him, I thanked him. And I said, you know, Sri Sri, I just wanted to thank you because in that dark time, your voice is a ray of hope. Our country is better than this. Our people are better than this. Our history and our culture is better than this. And as you know, Mary, you were at the India Conference at Harvard, and Dave that pointed out, our rich cultural history. And for me, being here for the 2 days was an amazing experience. And to see that message of love, which is
so. Thank you so much, Amit. And anything else you want to say about AOL?
Well, I had a wonderful time here. This is the largest event of its kind in the country. So we're very honored to be a part of this. And South Asian Arts Council, I think in many ways, is synced to this mission. Because here you saw the world heritage, the cultural, all of that. It's bringing all different walks of people in the same room.
Togetherness, meet so many new people in a one day.
Is it? get happy Boston. Right? It's happy.
Thank you so much, Amit. Welcome at BDC TV series. What the message you are giving to the common people who are not aware with the yoga?
Say, when your goal in your life is to be happy and to bring happiness around you, find the inner happiness first. So to find happiness in your life, you need to go into meditation.
It is important, yes, of course. So, you know, I saw so many young people today on yesterday. So how did you get them in?
You know, because the spirituality that we teach is very juicy. It's very, in the sense, it brings joy to your life. Almost immediately. It's not that I give a technique, ask them to practice for so many years, one day you will be happy. No. Here you do the practice and you are happy right now. Not only that, it enhances one's intuitive power, it brings your energy level higher, it makes you very innovative, and all our young people want that. Moreover, on top of all this, it brings such a joyful atmosphere around you. Often people stay away from spirituality because it is very dull, morose and too serious. Young people don't want that. They want to have more fun. And they see the genuine happiness, genuine fun is in spirituality. That's why my first book is also called God Loves Fun.
You just did in India the big cultural event. Would you like to do the same in USA or in Boston, of course?
Well, it depends on the local team here. Of course, 5 years ago we did it in Germany for Europe. And then 10 years back we did it in Bangalore. This year it was 35 years of Art of Living celebration. And we, of course, did it in Delhi, where the largest stage in the world was constructed. 7 acres of stage, 36,000 artists were on the stage. So to do something of that big scale here, I think a lot of work need to be.
And Boston is very vibrant and very dedicated volunteer you have here. Yeah. I think they will help you.
Sure, we will see.
Thank you so much, Vinci. Thank you. Right now we have Dhanshiri with us, and one of the key organizers she is, and let's talk to her. Dhanshiri, welcome at BDC TV.
Thank you.
One of the main organizer of today's event, and it's a big, huge success. Congratulations for your successful event.
Thank you so much, Radhiya.
So tell me about, everything is going very good, I know, but tell me about your experience after the completing or giving a successful event in Boston.
Oh, it feels phenomenal. Actually, the biggest thing that I learned is with really great teamwork, you can do amazing things. And we have an amazing, amazing team of volunteers, so dedicated and motivated volunteers. I think this was nothing. I think a lot more bigger things are in future.
You are running so many other sub-chapters right here in Rhode Island and Massachusetts. So do you want to extend to some other states, or what is your plan?
Well, Art of Living is in now 152 countries, and US is just one of the countries. Within the US, we have more than 500 centers. In Boston, we have 10 satellite centers. So, you know, it's not a business that we want to grow or anything. It's just more people we can reach is great. And so it's really the happiness ride, you know. So everyone's welcome. And we're just happy doing this.
So as 100% based on volunteers, tell me about how it happened. It's a huge thing.
Absolutely. It's a really great thing. And it is the biggest volunteer-run organization. And I think some time ago I had put it on Facebook, and I really like that analogy. You know, you start gardening and you grow tomatoes and you become master at it, right? And so you have lots of tomatoes and you do everything you want to do with it, make a sauce for a year, and then you still have so many left. So what do you do then? You start sharing. So that's what happens with happiness. And with meditation and breathing techniques that we teach on our courses, the stress level goes so down that you can actually experience the happiness and everything else, that wonderful things that life has to offer. And it's just so much of happiness and joy that you start sharing it. And that's how we have so many volunteers and so many dedicated volunteers. That is really the secret.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like happiness attracts happiness.
Absolutely.
Right? And it happened with the AOL. And anything else you want to share about your upcoming events or whatever you have in near future?
We definitely want to do bigger events than this, and we are hoping that this happiness wave continues in Boston. That's it.
Thank you so much, Dhanshri. We'll be right back.